Good day, everyone. J7409 here. We're going to check out the severe weather situation today. Everything you see in the yellow here in Texas, this is a tornado watch that's in effect right now. When we move on across, you see a little bit of orange right up in here. That is a severe thunderstorm warning. Wherever you see these little orange blocks. Now, when we get to the pink areas, right down in here, this is all in Texas. This is severe thunderstorm warnings, okay, and watches. So, everything's going on in Texas at the moment, but folks, I cannot stress enough what's going to happen. All of this severe weather is going to be going like this as the day goes on. It's going to be stretching right across like this as the day goes on. Everybody go ahead and get prepared because it's on the way. This weather map is good for today. It started at 8 a.m. this morning. This is what it looks like it's going to be like for the next 24 hours. It's good through tomorrow morning at 8 a.m. Now, this severe weather I was talking about, see, and the watches and warnings forecast now is mostly over in this area. It's going to be moving over into Louisiana. Little bit of the Florida Panhandle might have some severe weather. Alabama, Mississippi, Western Tennessee, Western Kentucky. You guys are going to get heavy rain and flooding possible. Wherever you see these red marks, heavy rain and flooding possible. But this area right in here is going to be the most of the severe outbreak of weather that could happen today. Down in Florida, you've got some rain going on, looking like that in the Fort Myers, Florida area today. Very warm, 88, only a small 20% chance of rain probably this afternoon, looking like Sunday night's going to be the greatest chance of thunderstorms and rain at 40%. Now, we've had flooding, and more rain is coming to Idaho. Emmett, Idaho, 70% chance of rain tonight, and this chance of rain will vary in percentage-wise, but it's going to continue through Tuesday, so you guys be aware of that. Everything else that you see in blue is mixed precipitation, except for this area right in here in Colorado and Wyoming. This is snow for you guys in this area. Folks, what I'm about to tell you, I really don't want to, but just hold on. First up for today, this is the area of general thunderstorm activity that is outlined in green, the lighter green. You could have thunderstorm activity anywhere from New Mexico all the way up to the very tip of southern New Jersey. We have a marginal chance in the Piedmont area to the coast over in North Carolina. Also a marginal chance in areas of the Florida Panhandle, going all the way up through Alabama and in western Tennessee. Now, some portions of Tennessee could flood out. It's looking like mostly the Memphis metropolitan area is going to have the greatest chance of marginal rain. Now, for the tornado activity that's possible, the same area I showed you 3 or 4 days ago, folks, is right here in eastern Texas, Louisiana, and also Mississippi, where the red is. Where the brown is, that's not ruling out anything there either. Now, I'm not saying you guys are going to have a tornado. I'm not saying you're not going to have a tornado. But what I am saying is, if you live anywhere in this red to brown to yellow area, please be aware of what's going on. I've already been checking so much stuff this morning, but this is the easiest way just to show it to you. This is mainly concerning this area right in here where it is pink, and it's not good, people. But first of all, these storms, like I said, if you live in anywhere of these other areas, you need to be aware. Numerous severe thunderstorms capable of producing tornadoes, wind damage, and large hail are expected. It's expected to happen across parts of East Texas, Louisiana, southern Arkansas, Mississippi, western Alabama, and the surrounding areas starting later today, going through tonight. Now, I hate to tell you this, folks, but there is a potential for long track tornadoes. They could be possible, and also possible a regional outbreak of tornadoes could occur across parts of this pink area. Now, the rapid forecast soundings across the moist sector from Monroe, Louisiana, southward to Alexandria, Louisiana, show the CAPE values of 2,000 to 2,500 JK range. Now, with that and a deep layer shear in the forecast steadily increase due to the approach of a mid-level jet with the forecast soundings, show a 0 to 6 km wind shear of 50 to 60 knots by late this afternoon. Now, when this happens, this is going to be combined with strong low-level shear, and it's going to be favorable for supercells and tornadoes across this pink area that you're looking at, and anywhere else in the yellow, the orange. That's your greatest chance of this happening today, okay? Now, the 0 to 3 km storm relative helicities are forecast to be anywhere from 350 to 450 range, and that's going to support strong tornadoes with more dominant supercells near the axis of this low-level jet. That is what's going to make the potential for long-track tornadoes, and it's going to be possible that this happens. Tornadoes, it's just go and go and go and go. Also possible, a regional outbreak of tornadoes could occur across this area. Now, by early evening, the cluster of severe storms is forecast to move into southwestern and central Mississippi. That's where the potential for the strong tornadoes will continue. However, the wind damage threat may become more of the dominant hazard as the convection moves further to the east. The instability could be a little weaker. So hopefully it's going to die down. Once it gets through Texas, Louisiana, not saying you're not going to get it when you get over in this area of Mississippi, is when the chance could die down. If you're in the western sections or down south here in any of this pink, your chances aren't going to die down. They're still going to be possible. Now, for northern South Carolina and central and eastern North Carolina and far east Virginia, this southwest mid-level flow is going to be in place across the east coast today. And I've got cloudy skies. I've got nasty thunderstorms coming too. It's everywhere, folks, where you see the colors. It doesn't matter if it's 5%. Doesn't mean you're going to have a tornado, but you're going to have some very nasty storms that could, in springtime, spawn a tornado. And even if it's not a tornado, downdraft winds, I've seen downdraft winds from these things that do the same damage as a tornado. It's just not a larger spot. It's concealed to mostly a smaller spot. There's going to be hail, big hail with these things. So, folks, I've tried to warn you. Please be aware. I'll hang around for most of today. I see anything, I'll try to get it up and go live if I have to be with you. This morning already we have had 4 severe thunderstorm warnings to appear, all of this in Texas, and 1 tornado warning. I'm not sure, I think this may have been the tornado warning. It's probably out of date now. But I just want to make you aware. Let's make this a little bigger. It may be out of date, it may not be out of date. This was at 7:32. It was a tornado. It didn't contain hail. It was located over Menard, moving northeast at 20 miles per hour. So as I was trying to explain, all of these storms now that you see, these severe storms, thunderstorms, the closer they get to this line right over in here, the more they're going to intensify. You have a chance of a PDS tornado today anywhere in these areas through here. So be aware, my friends. I love you all. Please subscribe. Please share this information with your friends, your family, and on your social media. If you want to help me out, I'd appreciate it by doing that to help me get the word out. I love you all. Stay safe. Peace, love, and kindness to all. Thanks for watching.